So, hello everyone. Today we will look how we should keep the coat nice and brush and keep the daily care of a miniature schnauzer, actually of any breed. We need a few tools for that. We need a brush. It's important that it's a soft brush, not a brush which is breaking hair or pulling too much. So this is our volumizer medium, which is, you can see, very soft in this. Then we have two. Two combs. Both of them are turning the pins, and the pins are made that they are not too sharp but not too dull. It's just ideal for taking good care and keep your dog without mats. Then we have the big brush, which will be better for standard schnauzer or giant schnauzer. And then we have the small brush, also with the soft platform, which is very good for the small areas like underarms or on the stomach and so on. So we take first, before we start to really comb through, we will start with the brush. What about here? Go well through the hair. I need to brush it. Can we see? Stay. And from all directions. And I'm always lifting them, taking on the stomach, up and down. Good boy. And under the arm, because there is always matting. And this you should do at least each second day. And with the beard. Take care, if you are unsure with the eyes, then cover the eye like this and brush around so you can't harm the eyes. Good boy. Then the eyebrow a little. Good. This is simply the daily care you should do with your miniature schnauzer. Either you go to groomer or not, this is something what you should do actually daily. These 10 minutes you can always offer on your little dog to brush them through. So first you brush them. Now let's say it's brushed, but that's not enough. A lot of people are just doing this a little on the surface and thinks, you know, the dog is brushed. No, it's not enough. First, you have to be sure that there are no mats and brush the hair really totally through. And after that, you take one of these combs. I usually use the double or the short pins. And then you lie it totally to the skin and go through. You can see when the dog is well done, all over. Totally light, that you can feel that you are on the skin. This is the way to keep your dog totally mat free, and your groomer will be happy for you. These pins are very good because they rotate, so they actually go between the hair and part them. They are not pulling, they just go between and nicely keep one hair from another. If we go to the back, all the way totally to the toe, and here you can see he has a little, so this we have to, good boy. There's something from the garden, until you go smoothly through the hair. and under the arm and on the underline. And the eyebrow, of course, and then the beard. This you have to go really carefully through. Oh god, we got a little matte. This way, stay this way down. Good. Good boy. So, nicely combed. Good. On the forceps and on the other legs. So, also on the inner side and in the flank and all the way here. And this, if you do this at least 2 times a week, if it's really bad, otherwise each second day, I would say, then you can keep your dog totally without meds, nicely clean, and then you can work with the coat after. That's all what we got from it, so it's really a good comb, which is not pulling tons of hair. What you should do daily also, not daily, but often, like I would say once a week, if you go to groomer and you only have your dog at home and you don't want to work the coat yourself, it will be very helpful for your groomer to take the undercoat. It's not so difficult, you just need undercoat knife and a rake. Our twinking is not cutting the coat, so you can safely use it, and then you need one of the undercoat knife. Actually, the rainbow will be fine enough, and you just lie it like this. Can we see? Mm-hmm. In water level with the and from the top of the head, on top of the head and down. It's important your knife isn't too sharp, because you can see how it's making the little wings around. It doesn't have really much of the undercoat, but you can also tie the coat a little and go like this. It's important it doesn't cut the hair, so it's just taking the undercoat. I can also take the Retrofine, which is a little more effective in this. The principle is the same, whatever you use. You can straighten the coat a little, the skin. Didn't you see anything? And you are going against my hand. You should come from this side.
I think there's too much light.
This is the Retro knife, fine, which is also taking fine. Stay. And you can see I'm pulling the skin so it's straight. And then I go cleaning the undercoat. If you don't want to strip at home, to do this like once a week will be enough to bring a good dog to your groomer, which will do all the other things. But also you can do all this between the stripping period. This is all the undercoat without any, take some of the loose hair, but with the rake, I don't think it will take much, because is pretty clean from undercoat. This is the good with this rake, that if there isn't anything to take, it doesn't take because it's not cutting, so they only cleaned very little. It doesn't have that much, so there is not much to work with. So that's how you remove the undercoat. You can also make them to sit a little down. Good boy. Stay. And it's always better to straighten the skin because then you can go nicely and take all the undercoat away. So this is what you need in daily days with your miniature schnauzer or many of the breeds. Remember, brushing through totally on the rear, under the arms. You can also take the small one for these total details if you really want to go very well. And for the feet, and here for the feet, and then take the medium for better grip on the other part. Remember to cover the eyes, not to harm them. It's a pretty smart trick because accident happens only once and the pins are sharp, so then you take the comb. This is the one with the short pins. It's not taking so deep, but it's keeping it well, totally to the skin. And the one with the double pins, stay in the beard. And then remove the undercoat. That's the daily care you can do with the maintenance of the coat on such a breed. Okay, that's it.